idea. I could have done
right.
it.
Right. 78 trillion cells in the body all working together. You're the only one who thinks you can do it alone.
Osmosis Jones has to be one of the strangest films to exist, but also at the same time, despite its box office bomb, one of the good things that came out of the film was its soundtrack, which was a mix between multiple hip-hop and rap songs from the time that was put into the film. And today, I'll be talking about the one song in the soundtrack that didn't age well. Shameless promoting time. As of this video, it turns out that 93.8 of you guys who watch my channel are not subscribed. I'd recommend subscribing to the channel because I do all sorts of content, mainly talking about Earthworm Jim, anime, iceberg videos, etc. Alright, now let's actually get back to the video. In Osmosis Jones, they had a lot of songs from various singers like ST Lunatics, Trick Daddy, Craig David, Nappy Root, and a couple more, and they also had remixes of several songs like Hot Blooded by Foreigner. But most importantly, they also had singers on board to create custom and exclusive songs. No, I say exclusive since some of these songs are kind of obscure and the only evidence of their existence were mainly this movie, those being Don't Be Mad by Sunshine Anderson and I Believe by R. Kelly, which not really ageable for what he did, and a song called Open, which was made by none other than Brandy Norwood herself.
Brandy! I mean Leah, what are you doing here?
Anyways, the song we'll be talking about is Cool Daddy Cool, which was a song made by Kid Rock and Joe C, rest in peace by the way. This song is played during the scene where Ozzy and Trix go to the Zit in order to find Drax and hear his plans, and while at the same time while they're there, there's a band called Kitty Rock which is performing the song Cool Daddy Cool, and if you couldn't already tell, the main singers are supposed to be references to both Joe C and Kid Rock, and also the name of the band itself. So now you're probably wondering, what's so controversial about this? Well, it's not the scene itself, it's more of the lyrics in the song. Just like any other children's film, oh my god, half of these songs are not appropriate to play in a children's film. Anyways, let's talk about these lyrics. I'll be saying and showing the following example of lyrics that didn't really do well in this song. Hoes all dormant, they stopping to swarm me to check out my fly gold rings. Grumbling on some pork rinds, kicking on some sex rhymes. I can't be your friend though, unless got some endo to smoke. They treat me like the mayor, cause I'm the biggest player. And yes, I know you guys are gonna be like, but Zebra, that's not inappropriate. In that scene, he holds up a picture of Mayor Fleming and kicks it into the air, just like the song. Yeah, I know that, but at the same time, the lyrics have a different meaning, minus the sugarcoating that they did. And the most controversial part, which is the main topic of the video, is quote, young ladies, I like them under HC. Some say it's statutory, but I say it's mandatory. Which, my god, this single lyric didn't age well. This is that one lyric that sparked controversy many decades later and didn't age well. And it seems like Warner Bros. Did leave out that part of the song as well as many of the other lyrics, but still kept in the endo lyrics. So as you can see, Kid Rock and Josie made a song that had lyrics talking about liking underage women. So now you're probably thinking, well, why did Kid Rock write those song lyrics? Couldn't he just write a song that would fit the movie and its theme? Well, what if I told you that this song wasn't actually made for the movie? According to several sources, the song wasn't made for the film, but instead it was an unreleased song for an album that never happened, that Warner Bros. Somehow got their hands on. My guess is that basically while they're looking for exclusive songs to have in the film, they probably asked them to get the permission to play one of his unreleased songs in order to advertise it as the exclusive. Also, I know it's worth noting that Joe C. actually passed away on November 16th of 2000, 9 months before the movie came out. Speaking of the soundtrack, what if I told you the film was to have a different soundtrack originally? Let me explain. In the 1998 draft, the movie had different songs in mind, and those songs didn't make it into the film. One of the songs was Fleetwood's song called Don't Stop Thinking About Tomorrow that was going to play during a driving scene, but most importantly, the song that they were originally going to play for the Zit. That's right, they were originally going to have the song Superfreak by Rick James play in the movie during the scene where they go to the Zit. The scene was actually a bit more different in the early script. Instead of a band being there performing the song, it was going to be a DJ playing records as Ozzy moves around the building. I'm not sure why the song was never in the movie. I'm guessing it might be because of licensing issues or something like that, but I'm most likely guessing it was because of the fact that they wanted an urban vibe for the film, since that's what they said in an early promo film reel.
The good news about the music is, no Broadway tunes! It's gonna be catered to the MTV generation. It's gonna be urban, street, hip-hop.
What the heck do you mean the MTV generation? What the heck does that mean? Only those that they either mean music or the edgy guys on the couch! Anyways, the lyrics didn't really spark drama until, I would say, 2022, 2023, where several articles and posts would be made talking about the song and its lyrics. Also, off topic, but I thought I mentioned one of the things they wrote in one of the articles that they made talking about the song. And they say, quote, Osmosis Jones goes to what appears to be a club of erotic dancers. At least someone called out the fact that in the scene where they go to the zit, it felt so off because of the dancers. But yet again, sounds like where Code Black did have a scene where they go to a strip club. Also, is it me or is that, how is it that every time I make a video talking about Osmosis Jones, I always have to bring up sales at work? Kinda weird. Anyways, several people on Twitter/X have called out Kid Rock for the lyrics, and it's worth noting that Kid Rock never really made any statements about the song from what I was able to find. But yeah, that's basically the story about this song, and from what I was able to find, if there's any more that I missed, let me know in the comments. Next time on the channel, I'll be talking about the cut content of Earth from Gym 1.